Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this tutorial about resumes. So I want you to hit that subscribe button because I want you to learn how to build out this awesome resume for your perfect job. So let's just jump right into it. Resumes, they are the first step to getting your dream job. Whether they like it or not, it depends on your layout, on your configuration, and of course on your skills. But it is the first knock on the company's door. So let's just talk about that, how you should create them, and some do's and don'ts about creating them. Now, I have created mine on resume.io. I am not affiliated in any kind to resume.io, but it really lays out a good interface, and you could download as a PDF if you wanted to. Of course, that is a paid version, but you could download the TXT or just maybe have this link, because yes, you can share its link, and yeah, it's live on their site and anybody can access your resume with a link. So my first advice is to create a master resume and then a short resume. Now on a master, you just dump everything in there, like all of your works, all of the things that you want to show and you are proud of. Now, as you can see, there are these kind of designs. You could choose between many designs. I prefer this one. So let's take a look at what you actually want to add in your resume. And I will open up the master one. So the first one is the job title, Senior iOS Engineer. Now this should be basically the title that you are applying to. And of course you have to have that experience as well. First name, last name, your photo. It should be relatively professional, like a simple photo, not a party photo, of course, or not something of an avatar or something like that. Email and phone, it's good to have. And next up, we have our professional summary. Now, this is at the very top of your resume. It's very important because many recruiters will only read this part. So if they don't like it or they consider that you are not a good fit for the job, they will do so according to your professional summary. So make sure you nail this one correctly. It should be real short, snappy, and to the point of what you are and what you represent. It should be, again, this could be replaced for different jobs that you apply to, but it should be, okay, I'm perfect for this job. Let's say you apply for a Swift job. Okay, I know Swift for such and such years. Or if you apply for Objective-C, I have been working in Objective-C for 10 years, and so on. So what I have here is writing iOS code full-time for 8+ years. As you can see, I omitted I have been writing. These kind of words can be omitted in resumes. As you can see, passionate about teaching others how to code. And some stats that prove my point. And YouTube, I need to update this. I have over 460k views by now. Udemy, I believe it's 32k students. Instagram, 12k plus followers. So yeah, this kind of bulleted stuff is really, really nice because they can skim over it and get a glance of your experience and what you are about. Okay, next slide. Websites and social links. If you have any social links, you should. LinkedIn, GitHub, maybe YouTube, Instagram. I didn't really matter what you add in next. Maybe your portfolio. And as you can see, I have this rebeloper.com portfolio. So let's jump into the portfolio part here. And you should have, this could be added onto GitHub or maybe some free service. I have here a list of my favorite works. Let's take a look at Capture. And you should start off with a description of what the app does. A lot of pictures, maybe a lot of iPhones, the recent iPhones with mockups. Here you can see from idea to app, social, again, good UI that you have created, and maybe and the development stack that you used, AV Foundation, Firebase, like. This means that we are using likes for the post, newsfeed, and so on. And delivered in 7 weeks, if that is a good fit for you. Most importantly, show that you are capable of doing these kind of apps and with a lot of images. Like it, click the hamburger menu and hire us. And yes, you can hire me too. Just click in here and select hire us and just scroll down. Yep, ideas are nothing. Execution is the game. You just scroll down and complete this form with just a few questions, and I do mentoring and app building too. So let's go over back to our resume and move forward with the skills. Now, I have selected don't show experience level because experience is kind of vague. What does it mean that you are an expert or you're a beginner? And maybe you don't want to add in that you are a beginner, let's say in UI kit or something like that. Make sure you list out all of your strengths, like Swift UI kit, Swift UI, and so on, Stripe, Firebase, RX Swift. And I wouldn't add in here the experience level. Now, experience and skills. Now, I'm a front-end developer and a back-end developer, but on the back-end developer, I just use Firebase. So on the front-end developer, I like to show off all of my screens, like build and launch 40 plus apps and games, extensive knowledge and use of CocoaPod and so on. So MVVM, React programming, dynamic links, so whatnot. Everything that you can do, you can add here for your skills. And of course, source control. Now, this experience and skills, you could add in here some apps too if you wanted to, but what I like to do, because I'm into contracting and I have been since I have created my own company, is that under the employment history, if you don't have other employers throughout your lifetime, then you could add in your projects. And that's what is what I did. Contracting, full stack developer at Hey Latitude, full stack developer at Seed by the LLC. So make sure that your employment history is kind of your app portfolio if you are a solopreneur. Okay, and here just the regular stuff, the employer, start and end date, and again bullet points detailing what you did and what are your strengths. Now make sure that you add in here also your soft skills. Maybe you were communicating with some clients, maybe you held some meetings. Make sure you add them in here too, because yes, skills, they are hard skills. Soft skills can be added here. Language, English. I'm a native speaker English. Go ahead and add in any other languages that you already know. Education. I just added this here because it's kind of an Easter egg that I graduated in fine arts acting, and something that really spices up your resume. You can add any place here. Education is my part. It could be something else for your case. If you don't have former education, you could omit this, but yeah, I just like to show them because most of the time they ask, oh, you're an actor, and how come you became a developer? So that is a really interesting topic to start off the talk and then move on to more serious stuff. Okay, other parts you can add custom sections like hobbies, references, courses, internships. If that applies to you, you can add them if you wanted to. But make sure that it is some sort of around one and maybe two pages, but one is ideal because as you can see in my master resume, I have quite a lot of stuff going on here. I have almost 3 pages in full. So there you go. And you could download this as PDF if you pay for it. You don't have to if you don't want to, but this is a good template. or you could just share the link, and I will show you. If you tap on here, you can share a link and send it over. Okay, let's move so this is the master. So let's move on to the short one. And let me just close this off. As I told you, you should consider shrunking your resume to one page, because nobody will read that. So, and they are quite annoyed by that. So if your resume is sweet and short, the better. So create a duplicate of it, and then just omit or just shorten everything. I just left the professional summary as is, added all of those links because they are on the right. And now skills, the same experience and skills. Now it's the same. The only thing that I have changed here is the employment history and co-founder and iOS developer at Rebeloper. Now I have changed all of that because I wanted to show them my kind of timeline, and the shorter the better again, and make sure you add in here your strengths again, languages, education, and so on. By the way, I do have my Rebeloper link here, so they can actually take a look at my work, your portfolio, so to say. And basically that is it. Let's take a look at this preview right now, and it is much sweeter and shorter. Of course, if you don't want to download it as a PDF, you could shrunk it into let's say one page. I only have dedication on this part, so it's really just the small stuff, and just shrunk it when I want to, or I can just share the link. Okay, now that is it for creating your resumes. Again, just to recap, make it sweet and short, make it to the point, and add in your strengths as your skills. So now you know how you can create your perfect resume. I hope you will land your dream job with those. So I want you to hit that notification bell, because in my next video, we are going to talk about UI stack views and how you can use them. And we are going to do an advanced tutorial on them. Now, hit that notification bell, because in the meantime, I want you to watch these two videos as well. I talk a lot about SwiftUI, iOS development in general. So make sure to check out these videos as well. And as always, I will see you in the next one.